Sensei Jay with Vidyuu. Today in this video, I want to show how to create an optimized three-dimensional logo in Blender. So to create the file that will go into Blender, I'm going to use a free software called Inkscape, and I'll leave a link to that. But basically, Inkscape works with SVG files, which is short for Scalable Vector Graphics Files. So what I'm going to do is start by dragging my logo into Inkscape and then just selecting OK. And you can see that this is a transparent PNG file. So right now it's sort of fitting on the page. And if I use my mouse wheel, I can scroll up and down. If I hold shift and use the mouse wheel, it scrolls side to side. And if I hit control and the mouse wheel, then it scrolls in and out. The deal is this needs to be increased in size quite a bit. And if I just grab this handle, I can do that. But unfortunately, it's also stretching it too. But if I hold the control key, then it will maintain its aspect ratio. Also, if I hit the shift key, then it will center it where it was before. And I'm going to make it about this big, which you would think, wow, that's really big. But in Inkscape, if it was only the size of the page, then when I bring it into Blender, it's really super tiny. So this is about the size that it needs to be a reasonable size in Blender. Don't ask me why, that's just how it is. Because this is a transparent PNG file, it will be able to trace the outline of it very easily. What I will do is select Path and then Trace Bitmap. And the shortcut is Shift-Alt-B. And when I hit that, then I get a pop-up menu. That pop-up menu, I can make some adjustments here, but I won't actually have to. All I have to do is hit OK. And you can see that it has created a preview of the trace bitmap. So now I can drop that menu. And if I just grab the trace bitmap and slide it over a little bit, you can see that it is basically a copy of the original. Now I'll select the original and just delete it. This, however, is an SVG file, a scalable vector graphic. And I will go ahead and save this to bring into Blender. So File, Save, and then I will rename this Vidyuu logo and click Save. Now I will go into Blender. In Blender, I'm just going to go ahead and select everything and delete it. And then I will go to File, Import, and select a scalable vector graphics file or an SVG file. Navigating to where I have that, I will just double click it. All right, so now you can see, and I told you it was about the right size that I want it to be. Selecting this, you can see that it is a path file, and down here under the object data properties, I can mess with that. But before I do that, let me go ahead and rotate it 90 degrees here. And then if I look at it from the front, maybe I'll grab it and just lift it up a bit. Okay, I just want it to be sort of in a place where I can see it. Okay, now going back to the object properties, if I twirl open geometry, you'll see extrude here. And if I just grab this and slide it to the right, maybe about 0.2 or so, it's to taste, then it extrudes it. So this is not actually usable yet because it's not a mesh. It's still just a SVG file. So what I'm going to do is convert it to a mesh. And the way I'm going to do that is by selecting Object, Convert, and change it from a curve to a mesh. And now you can see that it has the familiar triangle with the nodes on it. Okay. All right. Now, this actually is usable right now. However, there is a problem. If I twirl open this drop-down menu and select Statistics, you can see that we have 5,784 vertices. That's a lot of vertices. If I go to edit mode and select all, you can see that there's a bunch of vertices here. And really, all of these vertices don't need to be here. So we are going to do something that will allow us to remove most of the vertices that are in this model and still maintain its basic shape and look pretty darn good. So I'm going to go back into object mode, and then I'm going to select the modifier properties menu and add modifier. And the modifier I'm going to add is the decimate modifier. Decimate is exactly what it sounds like. Basically, we're going to decimate all of the vertices that we possibly can while continuing to maintain the shape as best as it can in this model. So I'm just going to take this ratio and start dragging it down, and you can see that the vertice count as well as the face count, and it's also here, is coming down. But if you look at the model as I move that, the model doesn't change a whole lot. So I think we're okay. Now, if I keep going down, then the model starts getting real ugly, right? Because, you know, now we're down to like 149 vertices, and that's not enough. So we're just going to go back up to about here. This is pretty good, right? I think it is. Yup. Maybe a little bit lower, maybe 0.1, maybe 10% of the original vertices, about 605 of them. I feel that that looks pretty good. So from here, I'm just going to go ahead and select apply. And now if I go back into edit mode, you can see that those vertices are much fewer in number. And so now I have a pretty nicely optimized 605 vertices for this entire model here. So now at this point, you can go ahead and UV unwrap it and add your texture to it and then do whatever you'd like. I'm Sensei Jay, and this has been how to create an optimized three-dimensional logo in Blender. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. Otherwise, thanks for watching.